Hey guys, welcome to the clubhouse. I'm Billy Jackson, and today's review is going to be on Borderlands. Okay, now, when I first heard that this movie was coming out 9 years ago, I was really excited. Even though I've never played the games, I respect them because a lot of people do love them, so they say it's a great game, I've just never played it. So I'm going into this movie, you know, totally blind to any Easter eggs or anything like that. I'm just excited about movies like this, you know, sci-fi, adventure, post-apocalyptic kind of movies. And knowing that Eli Roth was directing this, which he's normally a horror director, I thought this was going to be really gruesome. So here we are 9 years later. And the reviews for this movie that first came out, the first reactions have been terrible. I mean, people are just totally panning this movie. I mean, they do not like this movie, the fans so far. So I went in with very low expectations. And was it as bad as everybody says it was? No! I actually enjoyed this movie. I feel like a lot of reviewers and critics and fans nowadays, everything's just got to be perfect. It's got to be a masterpiece or else it's just crap. And that's not how it is with this movie. Now, I'm telling you right now, I'm going to be honest with you, it's not a good movie. If that makes any kind of sense. I understand that it's not a great movie, but it really felt like a satire to the kind of movies and shows that we've been having recently. And that made it fun for me. I had a lot of fun watching this movie. I am not going to lie. I'm not a bandwagoner. I don't just, you know, if people just hate this movie, I don't just automatically go in thinking I'm going to hate it. So I just hate it just because everybody has put it into my brain that they hate it. So I go into movies totally subjective, and my honest opinion about it is that I had a good time watching this movie. And especially with the stacked cast that it has. I mean, Jamie Lee Curtis, Cate Blanchett's one of my favorite actresses of all time. You got Kevin Hart. You got Jack Black playing the voice of the little robot. And when I first saw the first trailer for this movie and I saw the little robot, I honestly thought I was going to hate this little robot. I thought it was going to get on my nerves. Turns out, he was my favorite part of the movie. I actually liked him. I liked the humor that he brought to the film. Like I was saying before, it's not a good movie, but it is a fun movie to watch. So it's kind of, I'm dancing on the edge of a blade, I feel like, with this movie. Is it good? Is it bad? Is it just terrible like everybody else is saying? I think it's not any of those things. I think it's a good bad movie, if that makes sense. I mean, there are movies out there that you know that are bad, but you like watching them. You know, it's kind of a guilty pleasure. That's what I'm going to categorize this movie. It's going to be a guilty pleasure of mine because I know I'm going to watch it again. So it had to be somewhat entertaining, at least for me. So take my word with a grain of salt. You know, I usually give movies the benefit of the doubt, and 9 times out of 10, when other people hate movies, I kind of enjoy them for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe it's just me. But I think you'll have a good time at the theater. And it's already predicted that this movie isn't going to make any money. It's going to bomb. And I have a feeling it's because of reviewers saying that it's terrible. And guys, I'm telling you, it's not terrible. Now, does it have some bad CGI moments? Yes. Does it have some great CGI moments? Yes. Does it have bad jokes? Yes. Does it have some good jokes? Yes. So it kind of has, it's balancing itself, I felt like. And I wasn't bored at any minute. It felt like the pacing was really spot on. It felt fast-paced. It felt like it began and then it ended, and I had a great time. I laughed at a few moments. There were a few cringy moments that they tried to make me laugh that I couldn't. But all in all, I had a great time. And let me say this, as much as it has a stacked cast, I was not impressed with the acting in this movie at all. I think this is one of Jamie Lee Curtis's worst performances, honestly. But I still liked her character. You know, that's why I say it's kind of a yin and yang kind of thing with me in this movie. Like, I went in thinking it was just going to be horrible, And I walked out going, dang, that wasn't that bad. It wasn't great. It's not going to win any awards, but it really wasn't as bad as everybody else is saying. So if you value my opinion and we normally have the same opinion, then that means that you will probably have a good time watching this movie. And I say, go out and watch it. Don't expect any Oscar performances. Don't expect any award-winning effects or anything like that. But do expect to feel like you're watching a video game as it's playing out. That's what it felt like to me. And I had a good time. And let me just say, it felt great to see Cate Blanchett as kind of a superhero type character instead of a supervillain or a bad girl. You know, I loved her performance in this and I thought it was a great time. So there you go. But it's not all about what I think. What do you think? Have you seen Borderlands? Do you plan on watching it? Did you play the game? And if you did, what are the, you know, was it real similar to the game or was it not? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to like my videos and subscribe to my channel. And as always, make yourself happy every day. And the only way to do that is to remember the only thing stopping you is you stopping. Bam!